Hello and welcome to Kieser Design. If you're into high-end watches and cutting-edge technology like titanium 3D printing, this is the right video for you. We are here in the design studio again. As you can see, I'm sitting here with Carolin, the goldsmith. Say hello, Carolin.
Hello.
This time, we are going to talk about a major leap in innovation that we are doing with our watches. I think it helps me a lot that I'm not a traditional watchmaker, but an engineer. So I have a bit of a different take on things sometimes. And the things we've done in the past were pretty innovative already, right?
Yeah. For example, we were one of the first watch companies who took purple in our watches.
Yeah, now you can see purple watches.
It's pretty common.
Pretty common now.
Yeah.
But we started that pretty early.
Yeah.
Yeah. The anodization process itself.
Yeah.
I mean, getting titanium to shine in those vibrant colors on that level we do is pretty unique. And putting a watch case into an exoskeleton is also something the tragwerk.t stands out for.
Yes.
And that is actually a good keyword because we are talking about the exoskeleton, which will be the focus of our innovation today. I mean, it's the center of the tragwerk.t to have an outer case that protects the inner case, but actually how to pull it off was really, really difficult. I just thought out this super complex structure because it serves the purpose that I wanted it to serve perfectly, but manufacturing it was a big challenge. We pulled it off in the end.
Yeah.
It works fine. It's a really useful part. But my vision from the beginning always was to have one integrated piece, one single part the exoskeleton consists of. No seams, no screws, no compromises. And this was somewhat a compromise. So actually, I had a real eureka moment, so to say.
Yeah, what was that?
Yeah, well, I come from a world of machining, so turning metal into chips and make parts out of it. But as you can see, with these very fragile parts, most of the metal is actually turned into chips. So does it really make sense? Why don't we build up the part from zero and add material instead of subtracting it?
Mm-hmm. So that was the moment when you looked deeper into 3D printing technologies.
Metal 3D printing technology has reached a state now where we can actually use it to such an extent that we can make real products out of it.
Yeah.
And that is just amazing. I have been following the developments in that field for years now, and now I'm super happy to find that the quality has reached a level where we can use it in our high-end watches.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So, show the piece.
Okay, drum roll please. Here it is.
Touch.
Yeah. This is the raw part, right off the printer, and it's actually all I've ever dreamed of.
Yes.
It's a titanium exoskeleton. It's one piece. It wraps around the case perfectly. You can still see the layers. It was built in layers by a laser, and it's just amazing. Think of it. There was nothing but metal dust, and a laser turned it into this wonderful exoskeleton.
Yeah. You guys haven't seen it, but I have seen it. The day the package came with the with this part, Matthias put it out, and he looked like a child looking at a Christmas tree.
Yeah.
He was so satisfied and so happy.
Yeah.
Yes.
I mean, I've held parts in plastic, as I said before, but I mean, having this printed in titanium is simply awesome, and it gives so much opportunity for watch designs and improvements mm-hmm. that we can make. It's awesome.
And this is still the raw part.
Yeah.
So this is still pretty rough.
Yeah, it's not it ready for use in
yeah,
the watch.
Absolutely needs to be yeah. finished and
needs some tweaking,
yes.
geometrical tweaking,
yes.
bending,
yes.
And aligning.
Yeah.
But it's already very, very impressive.
Yeah. Should we maybe talk about how the process actually works?
I
don't know
that
if everyone is familiar with that. I mean, we like thought about that like for months now, mm-hmm, but maybe we should.
Yeah, and it's super interesting. I mean, as you can see here, that's our regular plastic 3D printer for the models that we make. And I've already printed one of the exoskeletons here for you. And what it does is actually it melts a little string of plastic,
mm-hmm.
Pushes it through a nozzle, and the nozzle then builds up layer by layer and creates the final part. Yeah?
Yeah,
you have support structures because you can't simply place material in thin air. You need something for it to rest upon. And this is classic plastic 3D printing, but not quite as titanium 3D printing works.
Yes. I mean, this is great. You can actually see all the proportions. You can see you can check the ergonomics, what we talked about before. This is super great tool to have when it's when it comes to prototyping.
Mm-hmm.
It helps a lot not to manufacture everything and every thought you have in your mind like right into metal or wood or clay or something like that. You can just press print and then it comes out and you can check directly how it looks like.
This is a very approachable commercial 3D printer that we have, and you can do it in your garage. And,
yes.
It has nothing to do with industrial metal 3D printing.
No, metal 3D printing works actually basically the same, so it builds up in layers.
That's true,
the same, but it can't just use a string of metal and melt that, and because the temperatures are too high.
Yeah,
that's not how that works.
Yeah. And it would be much too coarse. Wouldn't work. So how it actually is done is it uses a bed of very, very thin titanium powder and a laser to melt the powder in tiny little spots next to each other and weld the material together.
Yeah.
And then there is another layer added of this very, very fine titanium dust, and then the laser melts that spot by spot again and builds up the next layer. So in the end, you're having a big bed filled with titanium powder. You need to get rid of the excess powder, and all that's left is the final part.
Yeah, yeah. You come in, simply blow away all the excess powder.
Easy peasy.
Collect all the parts.
Get an industrial grade titanium 3D printer for $1 million and then you can get started.
Easy peasy.
No, unfortunately it's also not like that, and you can hardly watch the process because the lasers are so dangerous, they're so powerful.
Mm-hmm.
It's a highly explosive environment in those printers because of the fine titanium dust, which can blow up very easily, especially if you shoot it with a high energy laser.
Yeah.
So that's also why there is inert gas always blown into the chamber so that nothing happens there. And a friend of mine is also working in the laser industry, and they had a printer already blow up. Luckily nobody was hurt because the printer was running on its own, but it can happen. There are a lot of difficulties also precision-wise.
Yes, we had a lot of difficulties with the precision to get everything in the shape we actually wanted it.
Sometimes you get glitches with the gas flow is not right, for example.
You need to think about in which direction you build up, if you build up like horizontally vertically. Yes.
And it's like welding.
Mm-hmm.
You have a lot of tension in the material.
Yes.
because some of the parts cool faster than the others, or one of the sides has more stress than the other.
And then it comes out as completely
warped.
Warped,
yes. Doesn't work. So we are actually very, very happy that we found an excellent 3D printing partner.
Yes.
They do nothing but metal 3D printing, and especially titanium. They are here in Europe. They do most of the time is they print parts for medical applications, for aerospace, or for defense. So they really know their way around titanium parts.
Yes.
And I'm really happy that they were super excited about the project, actually. It took a lot of iterations, prototyping, optimizing back and forth, very open process, talking from engineers to engineers, was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
And the part quality that they provided then in the end is simply amazing.
Yeah, it's just awesome.
Yeah.
What's possible.
The 3D printed part is just a starting point. Right?
Yes.
Yeah, because you can see the surface of those two parts. One of them is finished and CNC milled and went through the hands of Carolin, and the other comes out of the 3D printer. It's a big difference. So after the 3D printing is done, I hand the parts over to Carolin, and then the magic starts.
So actually, for me, nothing changes at all. You had me some parts that are almost there, like some pretty rough shaped parts, and hand them over to me and just like, oh, okay, now make them look nice. And so what's actually different is that the metal structure is so much rougher than on these parts, for example. This is why
I can actually mill a lot finer than the metal 3D printer can print.
Yes, you're such a great machinist. Yes, but what I basically do is soften all the surfaces so that's comfortable to wear but also not dangerous to wear. And make everything look nice, make every angle how it's supposed to be.
Yeah, and it's actually crazy what Carolin does, because all the chamfers that run around the edge of the exoskeleton is only printed very, very roughly. And what Carolin actually does by hand and using a file and sanding paper is she does the anglage, basically, on those parts by hand and freely without any fixtures or anything or any guidance, just with her trained eye and a file. So what you get is a hand finished anglage exoskeleton. And that is, I'm really grateful to have your skilled hands here in the workshop.
Yeah.
One thing that was actually very important to me was that you can still see that it's a 3D printed part in the finished product, actually.
Yes.
And
it makes a great contrast between the finished straight lines. Everything is super soft, smooth. All the angles are right and stuff, and from inside you can still see the rough texture of the 3D print.
Yeah, we actually achieved that by leaving the inner surfaces rather rough. I mean, we still treat them nicely. You go over them with some abrasive and they are blasted, but you can still see the layer structure and you can see that it comes from just a different process. What we still needed to do with the 3D printed parts and what we did extensively was testing, because we needed to make sure that the 3D printed part has the same properties as the traditional milled parts.
We wanted to be absolutely sure that we can trust this exoskeleton, then you can trust this new exoskeleton. and
we did field testing, bending, durability tests. We just looked at the metal structure, and the mechanical properties are absolutely perfect.
Yes.
So here we have it, the first 3D printed titanium exoskeleton for the tragwerk.t, hand finished by Carolin. And obviously it's not worth anything without being placed in a watch. So that's what we're going to do next. It's going to be the basis of each and every tragwerk.t that we're about to build, but most importantly, for our new limited edition, and the release is right around the corner. We're going to assemble all the parts that we prepared already. You get a glimpse of what we do with beautifully anodized blue surfaces in our dial making series. So make sure to check it out.
Yes.
We're going to head back to the workshop now, assemble some prototypes, some watches. Thank you for watching. Thank you, Carolin, for sitting next to me.
You are welcome.
And as always, subscribe to the channel not to miss out on anything. Follow us on Instagram and see you in the next one.
Tschüss.